and he's touring with Status Quo soon, which has got nothing to do with Graham Bonnet at all. Here's Graham Bonnet with Warm Ride.
Come to me, baby, I got something to say. I've been changing your direction every step of the way. I bring emotion, and I bring desire, and I bring the potion to set you on fire.
We've got Genesis on the show, and this is their first appearance without their lead singer Peter Gabriel. It's off their album And Then There Were Three, and it's a new single called Follow You, Follow Me. Sorry about the poetry. There you are.
Right here by my side.
First up on the countdown Chartbusters this week is Bob Seger. A great song called Still the Same, debuting in Sydney and Melbourne. Money's first week in the national top 30 at number 28. He picks it, Baby Hold On. Patti Smith is celebrating the 18th anniversary of New Wave, and she's up three places this week from 19 to 16 with Because of the Night. Right, Harry Vander and George Young, you know them, don't you? They're producing an album for John Paul Young at the moment, and about 1977 they made a song called Hasten Peter under the name of Flash in the Pan. Well, they've got a new one out now, and it's called Down Among the Dead Men. G'day, Harry. G'day, George. This is their new single, another Rolls Royce one, I think.
Moonlit side.
and George with another $1 million. Russell Morris is back from America, and he's back and putting a band together made up of guys from, well, X-Taste and Renee Geyer. He's got a new album coming out soon called Retrospective, and we're just very lucky to have him on the show. This is Russell Morris solo for probably, well, the last time for a while. You'll see him without his band, and we'll have him and his band on the show real soon. But this is Russell Morris solo with one of the finest Australian compositions, I think, for a long, long time. It's a thing, it's a flashback, actually. It's a thing called On the Wings of an Eagle.
Well, I'm looking out on an overcast sky in the morning. I can hear the warning as it calls to you. As the birds migrate and the wind raised, I'll see the evil soaring, although I'm just a pawn in nature's game like you. Wahoo, wahoo, wahoo. On the wings of an eagle I find myself lifted through the sky. Lifted up above the world to sing. On the wings of an eagle I find myself lifted through the skies. Lifted up above the world to see. Can you see me? Can you see me? As the days roll on and the nights get long, the change seasons and the falling autumn leaves, they bring me down, they bring me down, they bring me down.
Okay, next up we have the Angels with a new single called Take a Long Line.
Withered hand, put his finger on a photo from an old magazine.
soon. Don't forget we've got Polly's Humdrum with the film clip of Grease and some old and new Brian Ferry. But right now we've got a new band from Perth called McLeod with a song called Marion.
So hard, but I never stand. Marianne, I shall see your face. I close my eyes, but it's every place. Marianne, I am chasing rainbows. I am chasing rainbows. And it's not too good for me. Whoa, burn my bridges, and I'm never looking back. Now I know what's on that track, and it's not too good for me. Lift up your face, I'll kiss the tears away. Marianne, no, please don't cry. It's easier on me this way, yeah. Chasing rainbows, I am chasing rainbows, and it's not too good for me. Whoa, burn my bridges, and I'm never looking back. No, I know what's on that track, and it's not too good for me.
And now I have to go away. It isn't fair. Danny, don't spoil it.
It's not spoiling it, Sandy. It's only making it better.
Danny, is this the end?
Well, in fact, that is not the end. That is, in fact, the start, the very, very start of the film of Grease. And that is the first time it's ever been shown in Australia, and we've got a lot more goodies coming on. Now, what we're going to do now, 5 weeks ago, I was over in Hollywood for the Grease premiere and for the party afterwards, and we had the chance to talk to all these amazing people. It was a bit of a hassle trying to get all these interviews because, like, we weren't supposed to be there, actually, but we managed to get them. So let's cross over to the Grease premiere outside Grauman's Theatre, LA, Hollywood.
Olivia, First of all, welcome to Countdown.
Thank you.
John, welcome to Countdown Australia.
Hi.
John.
Hi. How do you do? Best of luck with the movie. I know you're going to look great. Oh, we love it. All right?
Olivia, take care. Where did you get your prom dress?
Hey,
you
John!
Hello,
Countdown. Hello, Australia.
Coming to Greece, right? And that's that, right? But number one this week, mate.
Number one, probably right there.
Right?
Oh, yeah.
Third one.
Everlasting Love. Oh, yeah. I mean, Shadow Dancing is the third one. It
right.
is. And then we'll release Everlasting.
Susan, please look that way.
Oh, Australia.
Hello, Australia.
I mean, like, and what about Greece? I mean, what, have you seen the film yet?
Not yet. I'm going to hear the
soundtrack. Have you seen it?
I have to admit, I have seen it. Yes, I have.
Yeah. What do you think of it?
I think it's terrific.
Yeah?
Well, okay.
No,
I think it's
right.
It's very
okay. Now, being an actress, Susan, I know you know Olivia very well, right? What do you like as an actress?
I think she's.
Now,
terrific.
Being honest.
I really think she's terrific.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's super. I mean, it's a super breakthrough, and it's John Travolta's wonderful. He really is.
Hello. Colin Meldrum from Australia.
Good to see you, man.
Hiya, son.
I didn't know you were in town.
I didn't know I was in town either.
Oh, that's great.
Who's your lady?
Cheryl. My wife.
Cheryl.
How you doing?
Oh, Australia, you look
well,
great.
I know. What do you expect of this film?
Well, see, I don't really remember that much about the 50s.
Now, listen, I believe you've been working with Bernie Taupin.
Yeah.
And what can we expect? A new album out soon?
Yeah, real soon. We're working every night in the studio. In fact, it's one of our only nights off. So it's really exciting, too. We're all, like, really, really hyped up about it.
And, Cheryl, I've got to ask, new dance routine?
New ones?
Yeah.
Oh, yes, all the time.
Best dancer show, in the world.
This one.
Hope you enjoy the movie.
Oh, thank you very much.
Good to see you.
Okay, well, that was Alice and his lovely wife, Cheryl. Alice said he'll be coming out here later this year, and watch out for Alice Cooper in the movie Sergeant Peppers, which is due to be released around about November or December of this year. Now we're going to go to one of the numbers out of the Grease film. This actually isn't part of the Grease film. In fact, this was filmed at the party afterwards. It's Frankie Valli in the big gymnasium at Paramount Studios with the dancers, and this is the part of the act that they put on for us at the party afterwards. Frankie Valli with the Grease theme, written by Barry Gibb. We can be who we are. We send the word. as I said, that was at the Grease party, and what a party it was. And that is Frankie Valli's new single, and that is absolutely roaring up the American charts. In fact, it's in the top 20, so watch out for that one. As I said, we had a marvellous time at the party. Everyone came back to it. But let's go back outside Grauman's Theatre because we've got some more goodies to show you. Have a look at this one.
Fleur, am I?
Hi.
Okay, now listen, will you look in the camera?
Hello.
What are you expecting of the movie?
I hope it'll be really exciting. Yeah. I hope it does well. I'm serious.
Now, you said that, like you're always related to, so, like, you're going back to 50s music, like, and 60s music,
right,
with the,
like,
Beach Boys, you know?
Dion, stuff like that. It's from the 60s and the 50s. Like Chuck Berry.
So, like the movie, I mean, like, are you going to sort of expect all of that and then come out sort of either liking or hating it or what?
I can't like it, I'm sure. I'm sure I really am.
God bless you both.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, Mum.
See you there. You're on Australian TV, it's the first time we've had the pleasure to meet you, you've got the top 10 single at the moment.
Oh, I do.
So congratulations.
Oh, thank you very much.
I'd just like you to say hello to Countdown out there.
And hello to Countdown up there. Out there?
Yes.
Below it.
Down there, actually.
Oh, down there.
Yeah, right, down there.
I'll be there soon, by the way. I'm coming on a
tour. I know, and we've heard that.
Great.
Fantastic.
I can't wait to get it.
You're beautiful. First of all, I'd just like to say, Mr. Stigwood, welcome to Countdown Australia, and like, if you're the proudest man we can ever have, you are it.
Oh, thank you. That's a wonderful compliment. I'm very proud tonight to have Miss Lily Tomlin as my date.
Miss Tomlin, how do you do? Welcome to Countdown Australia.
Thank you.
And we'd just like to congratulate you as far as the Countdown is concerned for what you've done for the rock industry. I mean, like, you're the king.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Well, there you go. There's the man that that made the film. He's also the manager of the Bee Gees, also Eric Clapton. And I'm sure Robert would like me to say hi to his mum over in Adelaide. So hi to Mr. Stigwood. There you go. All right. Now we've got the most exclusive part of the Grease feature. And this is, in fact, this is the first time not only been seen on Australian television, but in television right throughout the world. In fact, it was refused in America and Britain to be allowed to show this particular piece of the film. It's at the end of the film. It's the hit single, You're the One That I Want. And before we're going to show this, we're going to show an interview with a guy from Melbourne who went over to England. He used to be in a group called The Strangers. John Farrow used to play guitar and do the lead singing. He used to live in Melbourne, went across to England with Olivia, wrote a couple of songs with her, then started to produce her records, went to America, and then they finally asked him if he'd like to write the score for Grease. Then they asked him if he'd like to produce it. Then they asked him if he'd like to write the number for John Olivia. He wrote this number, he produced this number, Johnny Farrow. Let's have a talk to Johnny Farrow.
First of all, congratulations on the Grease soundtrack, but more so on the song, You're the One That I Want. How did you come around to write that?
Well, I was first asked to write a ballad for Olivia.
Right.
And when I'd finished that one...
What, for the movie, right?
For the movie, yeah. I think they probably wrote that ballad in to the movie. I'm not sure about that. And they liked that and said that maybe I should have a go at the duet because they'd asked several people in the business to do it but weren't really sure where it was going to come from. So they said I might as well try it. So I went home and tried it.
And over the years, like Olivia with her songs, with her looks and everything like that, has sort of become almost that national American girl next door image. Mm. And now, with this movie, suddenly, and especially with the record, there's Olivia sort of belting out a song, which and a lot of people think, God, I never knew, you know, Olivia could sing like that.
She's always had a great voice, and it's improved a lot, and particularly in about the last 18 months.
Yeah.
She's really worked very hard on her voice. She sings all the time. And I don't think she's ever been given credit for how good a singer she really is.
When Travolta has become so big, and it was your first time you've worked with him, mm-hmm. Was it hard to write for him then? I mean, like, knowing Olivia, but having to write for also a guy that you didn't know.
Not really, no. It was a little bit tricky with the range of that song. We had to swap it around a little bit. And Olivia took some of the higher lines in the verse that was meant for him, and we just swapped it around because it was ridiculously high for John, but he's got an amazing range, which I didn't really know about.
Thank you.
as I said, a very, very exclusive film clip, first seen on Countdown and first seen on, well, television throughout the world. So there you go. Grease, out right around Australia on August the 4th and August the 10th in Tasmania. And it'll be interesting to see what you think of it, because everyone can go to this film. So there you go. John, welcome to the show.
Thanks, mate.
It's been a long time since we've had you on.
Yeah, it has. Too long.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, you've got a great single now.
Yeah, thanks. Yeah, it's going well. The album's out soon. We'll keep our fingers crossed, you know.
Yeah, well, it should be a hit. Now, listen, this guy that we're about to show now, you actually toured with him.
Toured with him.
So we thought we'd sort of show a few of the old hits that he had.
Right.
Not that old, but, I mean, a few of the old ones, and then show the new ones. So here is Brian Ferry with Let's Stick Together, and then we're going to show you his new single. Here we go with Brian Ferry, Let's Stick Together, This Is Tomorrow, Then What Goes On. Okay, here's Brian Ferry with his very, very brand new single, and it's titled What Goes On. Brian Ferry. That was Brian Ferry with What Goes On, his new single. All right, the next guy on the show is our compere for today, Mr. John English. He's got an amazing talent, and we wish we could see him more on the show, but he's got so many other commitments. But he's also got what I think, and when everyone at the Countdown unit heard this, they said, this is going to be a hit. Mr. John English with a new single from his album, Fluent English, Words Are Not Enough.
The time is my big brother. Okay, national top 10, Shadow Dancing, Andy Gibb is number 10, and going up. Number 9 is Warren Zevon with Werewolves of London, also going up, we like that one. Number 8 is I Can't Stand the Rain, Eruption. Number 7, Too Much, Too Little, Too Late, Denise Williams and Johnny Mathis. I don't know if you like that. Number 6 is Love Is in the Air by Squeaker. Number 5 is Jack and Jill by Radio. I'm not sure about that one either. Number 4 is a song from Brian Brown. It's called Macho Man by the Village People. Number 3 is a good one, Baker Street by Jerry Rafferty. We like that one. Number 2 is You're the One That I Want. Olivia Newton-John, John Travolta again. And this is John English on behalf of Countdown saying good night. Thank you very much for having us. And well, they're going to leave you this week with the number... And, oh, it's my imitation of Mark Holden. We're going to leave you this week with the number one hit by Boney M. It's called The Rivers of Babylon. Good night.